When somebody says San Francisco, what do you think of?
Rice-a-roni. No, when I think of...
I'm old.
I think the character in the movie has a big fall, but I think it's also kind of a great realization. If you actually see people that have failed at social media, it lasts for a week, you know, and then there's a little bit of a cleanup, and then you can be yourself again.
You know, social media is playing a big role in our lives these days, and to talk about it in an interesting, new, meaningful way is an opportunity that Kaylee's taken with this film and Sherwin's taken, and I think it's important to talk about, especially in a fun way, you know?
What did you think about when you heard that Usher's in this movie?
Usher's great. I met Usher a couple of years before the movie, which was super fantastic, and I got to teach Usher how to play backgammon. So I will forever take that one. So when I found out it was in the movie, it was even better.
Favorite Usher song?
Oh man, you remind me. Taking it back to the 90s. Yeah, no, I mean, old school for sure, for sure.
What about this Usher kid over here? He's in the movie. I mean, how special is that to you?
Oh, I mean, it was amazing. It was so fun. I was nervous to meet him, and he was just easy to work with, and it was really fun, and he gave me his phone number, you know. I've never called him. That's out of respect.
No drunk dial?
No drunk dials. A few times where I've really wanted to, for
if
sure.
If you drunk dialed him, what would you ask? What would you say? What would be the...
I want to call him right now and see if it's even the real number. That'd be great on camera.
How proud are you of your involvement in this film?
You know, always great to be a part of something that I feel is meaningful. But more than anything, something that is passionately supported and has that passionate foundation. You know, it was a no-brainer when she asked me to participate with her, you know, looking at what she'd written, reading me and my wife, having really consider, you know, really the DNA of who I am as an actor. And does it really fit this profile? And is this something that could be a contribution? Or is it just another passing moment? I really do think that this is the type of film that's going to wake people up. And also to be entertaining. It's a great love story. It's realistic. It has realistic views. I don't think that you can specifically categorize it to a specific group of people or age group. So I wanted to be a part of it. I wanted to support her as an independent filmmaker as well as an incredible actress. She actually did an amazing job as an actress.
Well, I mean, this is cool because you could do anything. You don't need to be in movies. Like, so when you go out of your way to be in a film, like...
Sure I do. I need to be in movies. I need to be on stage. I need to produce. I need to write. I need to act more. I need to do all of it. Act on stage, all of it. Because that's what, as you said, being Mr. Entertainment is about. And without those opportunities, without that window of opportunity to show that talent, it's just a word.
When somebody says San Francisco, what do you think of?
Rice-a-roni. No, when I think of...
I'm old.
When I think of San Francisco, I think of... I think of the fact that this is a booming city. I think that this is a city that is really defining what the rest of the world is doing.
Yeah.
And not just because of this film festival, but also too in technology. I mean, if you just look at the backdrop of it and you look at the type of people who are here, the type of camaraderie that you feel when you go to different social gatherings here in the city, this is the type of place that dreams really, you know, become reality. I mean, and they have been. I mean, billionaires have been made in this wonderful city.
We're looking out for more from Mr. Entertainment out here in the Bay Area. Thanks so much. It's my pleasure to meet you, my friend.
Enjoying the
moment. Thank you, brother.